Hello and welcome back to Chinkie Chong Place, Enter the Gungeon. What is that thing over there at the corner? Just kidding, we know what this is. This is a bullet we unlocked from last time. It's pretty interesting, so when you killed it at least one pass, and then you keep going down the gungeon, you will really see the bullet wearing cape look exactly like this one right now. All you have to do is keep him alive in the room, and then stay in the room long enough for him to go away. Rinse and repeat for 5 times, you will unlock him in your breach. Now, we did go through it last time, but we'll do it again. Main weapon is blasphemy. Infinite ammo does not reveal secret rooms. Special thing is that when you attack or do a swing at full health, it will also release the sword-shaped bullet out, and the swing will also break the enemy bullets, just like easier to say is like nuclear throws, but that only apply. Well, the projectile part only applies when you have full health. Second part is the cape or life ammo, I think. Who needs a bullet in there, better? So basically, you're immune to contact damage. When you touch enemy, you don't take damage, but you also increases your dodge roll damage because you know you're a bullet, and when you dodge roll, you sort of launch yourself out like a bullet. Yeah, talk to him. Say, hello, I'm bullet. Oh, you want me to get 22 of them? No problem. I did a couple of runs off camera just to try and do warm up. It's a powerful character, but at the same time, it has quite a learning curve. So easier to say is it's quite hard to be good at this character. Now, so here we're down in the gungeon and we can show you how the sword works. Here we go, holding the gigantic sword. Every time you do your trigger or left click, you do a swing. Because I'm full health right now, so I also send out a sword that does quite a bit of damage to first level enemies. So there you go, 2 shots, that kills the enemy. Okay. And when you swing, you can also just cut through the projectiles. So contact damage is quite increased as well. There you go. Cool. But you're not immune to bullets, so getting close doesn't guarantee your safety. And if you take damage, then you can't shoot your projectiles anymore until you get back to full health. So it's strong, but it has its trade-off. Okay, that was a bit scary. Shouldn't have done that. Be very careful with the explosions. But that worked out pretty well, I'd say. You can sort of do your swing around the corner. I don't know if that it does. Let's find it. That isn't exactly the way to test it. Try this one. Yeah, it's too hard to say because I saw the projectile fly off. Anyway. So health, in a way, is not exactly important to this character. Not that it's not important, but because you want to stay in full health for the sword to take effect. So more health doesn't really matter, because if you're not going to take damage, let's say you're able to achieve that, then more health is not really going to help, unless you're going to use other sword for your resolve. But now thinking about it, that logic applies to all kind of characters in the game as well. If you're not going to take any damage, then flawless getting a master round is totally useless, right? One thing to be careful of is every time you do a swing, your character move forward a little bit, so it's the direction that you're pointing to. Got to be careful with that, because sometimes if you're not being careful enough, you might send you off to the pit after you swing a sword. Since I'm full health doing the extra projectiles, you can just get close to the enemy enough to swing it, so you take the melee damage and the projectile damage. So when you're full health, it's pretty interesting weapon. Alright. Now, I'm not good enough to just rely on the contact damage to play the game for us, but if any players that can handle that, anything that can increase contact damage would be marvelous. So say Thorn Armor, last time we saw it but we couldn't buy it because we didn't have enough money, or yeah, any other items that increase your dodge roll might be very helpful as well. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention, when you press your reload button, it's actually holding up the sword to block projectiles like that. I've never really used it because I've got a dodge roll, so normally speaking I don't need that. So right now I'm not sure how effective it is. Like, I just failed there, but yeah, probably not my best resolve on dodging. But right now, saying that, character is fun. You can see it's a glitch chest. It's the first time I've seen this. I want to clear the room first. I think faintly remember that if you open it, it sort of teleports you to the next floor, I think. I don't want to take the risk though, so I'll just explore the whole floor first. I can buy an key anyway, so yeah. What's wrong already? But this character, yeah, you can tell very easily it can be very different with your playstyle, and setup can make this character very different from any other character as well. Speaking like for every other characters, including the robot that we unlocked last time. I just picked up that, forgot what it's called, something coin, key coin, iron coin. So you can see the three here, the three charges every time when you use it. Random room that you haven't explored, all the enemies will be killed. So if I use it now, one of the random rooms that in the floor, some assassin thing is gonna do all the work for us. And another chest. Well, I would rather open the green one, is it? Yeah? Where's the other chest? I just opened it. Silly. Put iron coin dummy. Armor I think is very important as well, because it protects you from taking damage. I have a feeling I'll go fight the boss first before going to get the chest, because I don't want to bet on my memory, because it really teleports me to another level right away. Then I want to make the most use out of it, because, well, not this way, I could have a chance to flawless the boss. You know, even if I didn't flawless it, oh, probably not the best boss to fight. I can still, you know, get an item out of it that will make it helpful. Now, keep a nice distance. We're using a sword right now more for the defense purpose, and just, you know, because you also shoot a projectile out. So, but damage wise, it's actually okay. If not, you know, if not decent, but to me it's like pretty good, judging by the fact that, you know, it has a not so good fire rate or fire speed, but infinite ammo plus very good damage at the first level bosses. It's good. I want to focus on dodging this one now. Saying that flaws might not be all that useful. I don't have the certain skill that allows me to prove that in action. So I'd rather probably dodge this one. Okay. Use that to break open a space for yourself. Oh, there we go. Nice force. And something nice, I can tell. It's a regular shotgun. In fact, it's pretty nice. I like it. Cool. So now, go to do our first glitch chest. Okay, I don't know what to expect, but here we go. Yep, straight up to another area. In fact, to level 2. Okay, so since it does teleport me right away, so I think it's safe to say that what happened now is I'm gonna fight two beholsters at once. Pretty scary, but that is first time. Yeah, there you go. He's gonna split in two. Yep, can't read all those things at all. I'm gonna use the shotgun a bit because it seems to be a better idea right now. It's like very intense right away at the start of the run. I do already use one flank, so I gotta be very careful here. Luckily they do, it seems to have a lower health count than just one beholster. Oh god. Okay, I'm still at full health, so if I want to use a sword, that's fine. Okay, and kill that missile there for us. That's good. Okay, more missile. Doesn't mean it's good because they're close to each other. We can kill them. Oh, the explosions. Okay, things are starting to go down now. And I can't take this for too long if we don't kill them in time. It's a bit too stressful. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Is any one of them dying yet? I can't focus fire because the position now they stand. Too much stuff to dodge. Reload. It's like, it's nice for them not to make a pit for me to fall onto, but it doesn't make it a whole lot better. Okay, ouch, wrong direction. That's my favorite parody boy group and hero. Nice attempt, maybe, but I think I made the good decision there for fighting a boss first. But yeah, let's do a game. So glitch chest. Probably not the best chest. I will change my comment until one day I killed the twin beholders at once. It is actually pretty hard and surprising. Alright, right now just pretend nothing happened. And start a run again. Was that run just then pity? I think so. I think a shotgun is a good pickup as well. And the fact that we worked so hard for a flawless. Yeah, it just didn't work out. Just like a lot of things in life. But we'll just keep going. I'd rather have a nice run than a stressful run. I'm kind of lazy, so yeah. And I do apologize if you're hearing any noise in the background. It just started raining outside. But it should not. Back to runner. Still waiting for our secret room or item shop. So because we don't do contact damage, so all they can do is knock us out, and we can just dodge roll into these Bobulons just like the small ones and kill them in a very nice and easy fashion. Okay. That was a bit close. Gotta be aware of the explosions since you're gonna get close to stuff. I just love the fact that you can play as one of their, well, it's not really one of your enemies because it does look different, but you know, something that can remind you as one of the most iconic character in the whole Enter the Gungeon franchise, you know, bullet cats. I'm pretty happy. And the face is just so darn cute. The face that the face that he's saying that I don't give a crap at all. Just so cool. Alright, so he's a blue one. Make sure he's not our mimic friend. Okay, and then we'll keep going. Hopefully for more keys before we get to the shop. Still possible. Cool. No keys. Let's go to shop first. And he's a key man. Mimic tooth necklace. I think that's the one that attracts more mimics. Not all bad, actually. If I have a gun, though, that is. Fighting them with a sword, I'm not all that confident. And we're about to get to the dead end. Well, not now, but soon, hopefully. Okay, so we need two keys for a chest and a blank. Yeah. And then a blue one. That's a really tough choice because I can only buy one key. Sort of is out of question, I'll buy that without thinking. Brick of cash is good too because it points you to your secret room. But it's, yeah, it's two keys, just a bit much. You know what? We'll do what can benefit us the most, which is open two chests. Increase accuracy. I think it's nice. You know, it increase all the guns' accuracy. So, oh, we get the Hajime carbine. That's right, some gun. So, imagine how we look right now. We're pointing a sword at an enemy that has a laser attachment. Alright. For the king. That's when they earn the G. They become for a king. Okay. That was a surprise. Left right hand of the king appeared, so ruins my flawless, but I'm still at full health, so okay. The defensive mechanism is making it a lot easier for now, because later enemies is gonna be a lot more difficult. But yeah, so I can tell some people might be very good at the characters, but not the bullet, or vice versa. You know, they might not be very good at other characters, extremely good at the bullet, or both, you know. So now I lost my flawless and half a heart, so I have to use the carbine. Alright, scrambler's good, in fact, very good. Pick up some ammo, nothing, can't buy a key. Or anything at all. Let's find a secret room actually. Where would it be? Let's start with the item. That's not a crack. Neither is that. Could be here. I do consider this character fun, but difficulty wise I would say it's hard. It's quite hard to master this. So if I can, I hope to gather every opportunity to get items out of it. And since I've got blanks with me, definitely want to find a secret room. So we'll use one blank here to make sure it's not there. And check our second item room. No, not here. Don't get fooled. I know there's an item that unlocks all the things for us in the Gungeon or similar fashion. I really want to get it. But for now, we'll just do what we can or we're supposed to. Seriously, we're working. Nope. I don't know. Could it be here? This was a lot easier to find cracks. It's easier to see. Much more visible. We're not here. Not maybe. Around here, I didn't check this part anyway. Nope, it's So which means I didn't check the room next to it as well. Nope. Oh, where can you be? Fireplace room? Possible. Otherwise, I'll try the elevator. Really though? I'm not really convinced, but if not, then I must be really missing something. It's so weird. Oh, infected. Not. A key is nice. That's nice. Make sure it's not a mimic. We'll get another key. Look. I want this. Just to make sure it does what I want it does. Unlocks all chests! A necklace made from the tooth of Mimic feels lucky. It's not even what I'm looking for. So that chest theoretically should be unlocked. But the gate is not exactly a chest. So. Well, that's still worth it, I would say. Because from now on our keys can... We'll basically save a lot of keys and does a lot more useful stuff for us now. So yeah, I'm pretty happy. Green chest. It's a valuable sacrifice, let's just say that way. Scrambler I want to save for the boss. Because of how easy it can make things for us. So for now, let's just use the sword. To try to get a more experience with the sword. Blast. Blank's fine. In fact, I need it. I bet I can just kill this. Ooh, nice. Should have done it too often because I just keep doing it for a few times. Yeah, it's pretty fun to do and it's a way to practice your reflex. It doesn't sound convincing at all. Alright, there we go. One more enemies. That's fine. Dodge your stuff first. That's nice. Okay, almost got hit there. And there. Nice and easy. And we'll keep going to the next room. Gunslinger first, as always. There you go. Right, thought they're gonna be grenades, but nope. Something easier to handle. Bandana, gotta be careful. Because you don't know when the bullet's gonna be in there. Okay. That makes these enemies a lot easier because you can just slash away the bullet. So, definitely worthwhile coming in here when I have a key. And since, you know, I don't need keys for the two chests in the item room. So, yeah. All I need now is one key. So I think that 2 key purchase for the necklace is definitely worth it. Although it does different things from what I imagine, but it's totally fine. It's a happy accident or happy mistake. Oh, God. It just had a hunch that, you know, want to make sure. Okay. Don't take damage. Can I slash you through the walls? Pull out my gun here. Just do some significant damage to you. Okay. Okay. He did drop a gun. Is it the Magnum? 30 special. I never used this before. The item of choice for investigative efforts. So it's just the normal gun that police use. Okay, slow fire speed, fire rate is okay. Big projectiles, that's all I can say for now. I don't actually know what it does. But well, it's a gun that we can spam with. Yeah, we'll wait and see. Okay. Again, don't rely on that too much. But good reflex, nonetheless. Fine, that makes it so much easier. Aha! by my worthy sword. Okay, okay, we need to take this. That's fine. It's scary. Fine. I can see how we can abuse it with a sword. If there's something that can give us a bit more protective, that'd be nice. So let's say the Gun Knight's armor set. It's definitely a good choice. Every time we go to a new floor, give you more, give you one piece of armor per set. That, well, not per set, but per item. A Gun Knight item that you have, and we're gonna do that Gunslinging's challenge. That hasn't done well to us. Me speak with me in a bridge at which hour though hasn't a moment to do so. But now though, we put forth a knave such as thee but never clear this forthcoming route without dodge rolling. Okay, that might be a bit tricky. Prove thee can, and we wilt reward be handsome. I'm not used to these kind of language. Oh, by the way, I need to talk to him in the bridge. I think that's what I'm trying to tell me to do. I'll do it when I get home. Grr. So instead of dodge rolling, I took the damage. That wasn't my choice. I should have used the sword. I thought I'm gonna be safe and use Germany carbine. Turns out I should have just used a sword all along. So we get the Jolter. Jolter's, yeah. Look, it's a gun that we don't always use, but it's a nice gun to have. I think it's a correct description of the gun. I don't think so. It's not at all description. It's more my opinion. But anyway. Oh, so yeah, all the checks are unlocked, but they're all mimics. So yeah, that still makes sense about what I say about the necklace. So nothing really changes, just as expected. There we go. That's probably one of the useless ring. Sometimes reviews the floor. Sometimes, every time when you go to a new floor. So not entirely say useful design. So it's something I think we can sell if we're now to. Oh, missed that shot. There's a grenade coming down this way. Cool. Things are still going okay, but I would like more armor when I can. So again, like I said earlier before, when you slash, make sure you don't fall down the pit by standing too close to it. Getting to shop fairly soon, but I can imagine probably level 3 the sword is gonna be not as much useful. This enemy is gonna be stronger unless it's a way to increase fire rate or damage. Lychee finger, yeah. Oh, you know what, I want to buy this. I need one more key to go in there, but I think sling is definitely worth it. Is it more worth it than the armor? Probably not. But instead of defending, I think the offense is a pretty good choice too. Ah, is that it? Okay. Oh, that's fine. Go ahead and fight those. You again. Where's your other half? Huh? Fine. We're doing a lot of damage still. Ooh. Use a blank dummy. That's what you have four of them for. There you go. Yep. Don't even need the sword for that. Ah. Took a bit by the face. Small BDs are really annoying. I just need to take care of those. Don't take any more damage, it's hard to recover your health back to full. Try not to rely on the blanks, but I'm not as good as I Imagine. One full heart is nice. In fact, very good. Our ammo. Oh yeah, I forgot the scrambler at all. Such a big, horrible mistake. So next level, we probably don't want to use our sword. There's not much of a point, I guess. I can find a secret room. In fact, I'll spend one here now. Again, just to make sure it's not there. And then I remember I never checked any item rooms, because when they go in there, I have to come out. Since they're all mimics infested. If I want to be lazy, I can still pick one more room to spam your blank to, you know, be lazy. I'll check the other item room first. Is the easiest assumption to guess where the item secret room is. Alright. Not there. Not. Oh, wait. Here it's right. That's cool. Ooh, that's nice. As much as I want a key. I'm still missing a chest. I'm not as happy as I thought. I'll pay on a visit just in case there's some way to do it. Nope, please, no. If I blank, nope. Fine, so we'll be on our way. There's not much we can do. Make sure there's no heart left on the ground that I didn't pick up. Nope. Okay. So we'll be gunning this place down with some limited resources, but again, we don't need keys for chests, it's a big plus. As long as I don't do stupid things while fighting the mimic. Here we go. I didn't actually reach level 3 in my off-camera play. So, as much as I know what to expect in level 4, as much as I know what to expect in level 3, I'm still a bit nervous. Okay, so you have to be mimic, is it? Yep. Is it a good idea to have the sword back up for defense? I think so. Just in case they're, you know, if they're plays, you need to slash. Not too bad if you're one-on-one with the enemy. Plague pistol. No, I don't like it as much anymore. Is this because you have to get close to do the poison damage as well? Yeah, that's a little minus for me. Oh, almost took it with the face. That's a hamburger still there. And you go down and die. Very good. We've got heaps of guns, so ammo should not be a problem anytime soon. And if we can get back to full health, we can use a sword for a moment until we can get us some ammo and money. Okay. Yep, keep firing. But I still need more defensive items, so gun knights or even tabletop would be very useful. In fact, they can create a lot of openings for us to use a sword. So yeah, it's a character that can make some normally not so impressive items to shine, and make some powerful weapon to shine even better. So let's say double vision. Now actually, double vision might not be as good with the sword, because all it does theoretically, it just double the sword that you send out. Right? So yeah, probably not as good comparing to other guns that you can pair them with. Okay. Our Jimmy Carbine is a crap, let's just be straight and honest. That's so good. So 600. That's why they give us 600 shots. You know what? Let's do this. We are one hit from death. For movement speed. Is it worth it? Hell no. Unless there's a shrine somewhere again to give me more health. Yeah, right now I'm pretty upset and regret my decision, so don't gamble, kids. Or whatever age group you're in. Viki? No. Armor? No. Can't afford it. Just be on our way. Oh, it's empty. Scramble, yeah, sure. Okay. Ooh. Alright. Well, you need another gun. There's 0.38. Oh, it is pretty crap. Fire rate is horrible, even with tap shooting. Oh, okay. One down, kill the mushroom first. Okay. I can use a sword again, but not when I'm half left. Okay. This is scary. When it get close to the corner, we'll just poke our heads out and slash it. If ever. Okay. Or one of these days. Nope. There we go. Oh, this might not look scary, but it's actually quite scary to do this. Ah! Alright, look, you know what? Let's go back to the bridge for now. I think it's a nice progress to play as a new character. And it's been fun, so let's go back and talk to the king. I think he wants something to do with us, normally just tell us to, you know, freak off. Ah! The young slinger! Thou hast brought me much amusement. Alloweth it never beast, said that I'm not a generous patron. We have donated this trinket to the acquisition department on thy behalf. Now move it along, slinger. Owl unlocked is a companion. I like owls. And again, I'm not used to these kind of speech, so bear with me over there. Portable torrent seem nice, face melter seem nice, magic lamp seem nice, tangle seem nice. Let's do one more run. Let's make this quick. And it doesn't matter if I take damage, that's fine. But last one I think will be good. It's quite different from what we normally get. Just simply the fact that ouch, that's not a good start. It's simply the fact that we have the mimic chest, the necklace. I think it's interesting. But, let's do a run that just simply uses sword to slash around. You know. That's how some products are made, you know, they're byproducts, they're just testing it. Turned out it worked nicely. So we're doing the same thing here. Trying to see if just slashing a sword might be even better than doing what we've been doing so far. No, it hasn't been working out. It could be my issue as well. Okay, here we go. Two hearts gone. Correction, half of our health are gone. That's fine. Keep going. See a chest, we'll open it right away. Where are you? Ta-da! There we go. There's a shotgun keen over there, two of them. I'm thinking there must be a reason why they designed this character to not take contact damage. Maybe because launching yourself on the enemies is the right way to go? Just go running. Make this fun. Yikes. If you can time your swings properly, I think it's totally possible to get up close and do this, right? Like then? Ouch. Or not that. Ouch. Dang it. Alright, so just barely a few minutes. So there we go. Well, I'm gonna put in this here. Thank you for watching. Please consider hitting the like button if you enjoyed the video, and we basically have a full house in the bridge right now, so next time we'll wonder what's gonna happen. And we'll see you next time. Goodbye.